Well, good morning, Matt.
Good morning. It's afternoon now.
Is it?
Yeah.
Good afternoon, Matt.
Afternoon.
It is afternoon. We've been here all morning videoing, getting the drone up, getting the Mavic 3 up, showing this beauty off. And this is a beautiful car. It is the, what is it, Matt? You tell me.
It is the McLaren MP4-12C.
How old is this particular
car? Is now what, 10-11 years old now?
11 years
old. Yeah, it still looks absolutely amazing.
It does look amazing, doesn't it?
Yep.
So we are here not just to show off this car and the beauty of it, but also to get you and show the viewers on my channel what you do with the poles. And what's it called? Car rig, isn't it?
It's called a rig shot. I call it a motion shot because it captures the car in motion, shows the car, or makes the car look like it's travelling at speed.
Right. And it does look fantastic. I mean, I don't know whether you remember, Matt, but you done this picture here, well, I'll put it up here, of my van, which I was very impressed with.
Yeah.
We had a bit of fun with that, didn't we?
Yeah, that was a few years ago now.
As you can see, the breakfast is there. Very good. But that was a few years back. And of course, Matt has perfected his editing skills on this particular photo shoot. And this is what you do, isn't it? I mean, you know, if you want to check Matthew Wheeler out on, what is it, Matt?
Heel and toe photography.
Heel and toe photography, there you go.
Facebook, Instagram, I've got a website.
There you go. So there you go. So check him out, because he's done some absolutely fantastic automotive photography. He is right up there. He's done some great stuff for a lot of famous people, actually, and a lot of different people in that area. So it's very interesting stuff. No further ado, we're going to get on with this car rig.
Yeah, I'm going to show you the process of how we set the car up, how we attach the rig to the car, the processes involved in the technique to produce the end image, and then later on in the video there'll be a time-lapse or a sped-up version of my editing technique, and then obviously you'll see the final image.
Well, I'm looking forward to that, and I hope you are, guys, and I think you will. It's a really interesting process. Yeah. So, with no further ado, I'm going to let you get on with it, Matt.
Just start by saying I've already prepped the car. The areas that I want to use, because I have to attach the carbon fiber boom to the car via suction cups, I've already cleaned the areas which I'm going to be using. I try as often as I can to use the glass. It's for me, I feel more comfortable, and it's the safest way to do it, because obviously doing what I do, there is always the potential for damage.
Yeah.
There is the potential for damage. However, I've never had it happen to me. But you do have to be very careful. You have to be selective about what you do do, where you place the cups, in terms of denting a panel, bending a panel, twisting, warping.
And needless to say, you are insured.
Of course. Yeah, I bought this kit from a guy called Justin. He owns the company called Car Camera Rig. They're based, I think if my memory serves me correctly, they're based near Birmingham. He's a top bloke. His aftercare service has been amazing. Any problems, any questions I've had, he's always been there. In fact, he is the guy who actually showed me how to use the rig in the first place. I went and done a workshop with him. So that is Car Camera Rig.
Okay, well, what I'll do, I'll put all the links for all this gear and everything we use here on the links below, as usual, so you can see where you can get them from. Very interesting stuff, this, I must say. Really good stuff. So what Matt's doing right now is just compressing the sucker onto the back window, and I'm sure he'll pick up on me if I say anything wrong, but that's presumably what you're doing, is it, Matt?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
So he's basically got one sucker on the back window here, and what he's going to do is put a pole through this section here, which will then go onto another sucker on this corner over here. And I'm only saying that because I've seen him do this before. And there you go, that's what he's going to put on there. And then he's going to put a carbon fibre pole, which is going to be, how long is the carbon fibre pole?
6 metres.
6 metres long. So can you get other lengths?
There are lengths. I mean, it's been a while since I've had this. I've had this kit for a while now. I think I'm correct in saying that this is the semi-pro kit. There right. is a pro kit, and I think that is 9 meters.
Okay, so you can get a 9 meter. Can you get shorter?
Possibly. I don't know actually. But when you see what I'm doing and the lens that I use, I wouldn't want to go any shorter. You'd be cropped in too close to the car.
Fair enough. Yep. That's good information to know. So I can see that you're used to doing this, because you're angling that just exactly where you want to be. So you're obviously very used to doing the camera car rigs.
I've got my go-to angles, which, you know, I've used, tried and tested. I've got my way of working around a car, and you know, when you are trying to make money out of it, you have to be able to work in the most efficient manner.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I have my go-to angles. If I've got more time, or, you know, I'm doing something where I want to be a bit more creative, or you know, something personal for myself, then, you know, of course, you know, you experiment with other angles.
Now you're going to go what, put the pole on?
Yeah.
Without sounding cliche, that's rather a large pole you got there.
If you look at it, that's upside down there. The camera might be able to pick it up the other way on the other side. There is the car camera rig. It is a carbon fibre boom, so it's lightweight. You know, there are people out there who make DIY kits, and, you know, you see some horrendous monstrosities, scaffolding poles and stuff like that being used.
What, on an expensive car like this?
Well, I would hope not, but I have seen it done.
Yeah.
If I were to drop that on the roof of the car, the chances of causing massive damage is very, you know, slim.
Yeah.
And that is the beauty of it.
Because it's so light.
But no, not only that, but the properties of the carbon fibre make it an excellent material to use for the boom. Rigidity and movement, and the locking system that it has. It's a really good, really good piece of kit.
Yeah, cool. We're just trying to find out whether we can get the McLaren in neutral and to get the handbrake off, because it's electronic. Because what Matt does with this is very clever. What you do is this is the pole, and you can see how long that pole is. And what he's going to do, once that's all connected, he's got his camera on the end, we'll be pushing that car to one rotation of the wheel. One rotation is all it takes, and you will get an amazing effect. But we're not going to show you that effect until the end. How much does a setup like this cost, Matt? Just the rig.
I think, and I got this rig 6 years ago, I think I must have paid about £2,000 for it.
That's quite an investment.
Yep.
And you've got to be serious at what you want to do here. and also know what you've got to do as well, to be fair. So what are you doing here?
This is all part of the stability of it. This is where the spar kit comes into play. Much like a tent, this is a guide or guide rope.
Yeah. And do you do this all by yourself?
Yep.
Right, okay. And you're trying to get tighten that up as much as possible, are you?
That's it.
Yeah. And so what you're saying is that pole, are you putting any more poles on, or?
No, that is the pole.
That is the pole.
Yep.
So that one pole keeps it all stiff and strong.
The spark is,
yeah.
I might be putting some more on, yeah.
Oh, okay,
so you. What I feel that I can get away with.
Right, okay.
If I feel that I can get away with just the one, then I'll put just the one on. If I feel there's too much movement with the wind, then I will put the other two on. I always keep going back and check the pressure on the vacuum, on the cups.
You do?
Yeah.
Does
yeah,
it
regularly. Can do.
Okay.
Once again, I've never had a problem, but it's a good routine to get into. Yeah. Obviously, when you look at the cup on the little button there, if it loses pressure, that starts to come out and there's a red line that you can see.
Right.
So I always go up to it. Every time I come back to the car, well, not every time, I try to every time come back to it.
Yeah.
I regularly check the vacuum on the cups just to make sure nothing's going to go wrong.
Right.
I'm going to leave this one off because I've just seen an issue. The issue with this is that my placement of the rig and the way that the door opens on the McLaren. Obviously the door comes up, if I'm going to put that in the way, to get Andy in later on to take the photos to make it look like someone's driving the car, he's not going to be able to get in if I've got the rig in the way.
Oh, good point.
So, you know, in all fairness, it doesn't look as though there's that much movement on the roof. So we'll try it without, and if necessary, I'll put one on the other side.
So you're saying, oh, shit.
Was he going to land?
I hope not. Well, he's not going to land at that speed, and there's the end of the runway.
That's his runway.
Is it?
I think we need to get out of the way.
I think he's going to land on the grass. Yeah, I think we better get the car out of the way. I think we'll be okay here, won't we? Yeah, we will. We'll be all right there.
Are we able to move your car,
yeah.
Andy? If you do it very gently and reverse over there.
Yeah. Oh, I so wish I could have videoed that.
What's the name of the guy? The name of the guy is Sean, isn't it?
Yes. Oh,
I think we better speak to this guy.
There's your photo, man. There's your photo.
Well done, well done. He must have seen us.
Yeah, oh god, yeah.
He gave us a bit of a scare.
I think that was his plan.
I think that was his what?
I think that was his plan.
Yeah.
Give us a bit of a scare.
Yeah. Go, ooh! He can't be landing, surely.
Should we go and talk to him?
Yeah. Yeah, we'll have a chat.
How many miles is it racked up then?
I hadn't a clue.
I was going to say, has he actually got it?
The mileometer's been round and round and round.
The old and the new look. The old and the new. Wow. Cool. Wow. Beautiful. Do you fly into Seething? Do you fly to Seething, do you?
Yeah. I've had that since I was 21.
Have you really? What, the...
50 years I've had
the
that.
Tiger Moth?
Yeah.
Wow.
I bought it in Australia when I was a lad. I used to cart all my
cutters
around in it.
Oh, wow.
Shearing. Lived in it virtually. I went round Australia in it.
Did you really?
I've been around Australia twice in it.
Wow.
I've been around New Zealand in it.
Amazing.
I've been around Africa in it.
Wow.
Amazing.
I've been up to the Arctic Circle.
That's amazing. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Not really.
Oh, I think it is.
It's just the experience of it.
Yeah. Incredible.
You've been across Europe in this as well?
Well, we drove back from Rome.
That's what I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
2 days before Christmas. There's a knob on the floor where you can pull. It's either you die of fumes or you die of cold. It's sort of, you're going to die both ways. You put a camera on that?
Yes, thing? It's a carbon fibre car roof, and I'd put a camera at the other end of it.
Jesus.
And then I push the car along on a long exposure technique on the camera, and it looks like the car's travelling hundreds of miles an hour.
Oh, I see.
So, yeah, it's actually unmoving.
Yeah.
It's less than a mile per hour, yeah.
Yeah, it's just being pushed along. Over push it, the, you know, one rotation of the wheel. That's all it needs.
I have used that as a camera car for car shoots here without the society because you can get a full 360.
Oh, yeah.
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 Very good.
Yeah, well, that's good. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. You've got your camera onto the pole.
Yep. So,
as we can see.
Yeah, the camera's on the pole using a Canon 5DS with a 1635mm lens. I've got the Nisi, I think it's the V5 filter system, so it's got a circular polarizing filter on the lens. Then I've got a six stop ND filter on. And then I've got a half grad filter on the front. Because we're doing a long exposure, I'm exposing for the car. The car is obviously white. Doing the long exposure, I'm gonna blow the sky out. So that's the reason why I'm putting the filters in, to reduce the amount of light being let into the camera.
Similar to what you do with long exposures.
Yeah, it's a long exposure technique, yeah. So yeah, I'm just going to have to get you to give me a hand to do this bit, and I will go the other side, and when I say go, I will push the car, then I'll get you to hit the button.
Trigger the button.
Yeah, that's it, and we will do the first exposure will be a 30 second exposure, then we'll do a second exposure at 15 or 13 seconds, then for the final exposure we'll put Andy the driver in and make it look like the car has actually got a driver in it.
Cool.
All right.
Sounds good.
Cool.
Right. Okay.
So you know what you're doing, press the trigger, tell me that you press it and I'll start rolling it, tell me when that releases so that I know I don't keep pushing it.
So I've got to press the shutter?
Yeah. And that's on a 10 second timer.
Okay.
And then it'll take it
in. Okay.
And then we're going to 30 seconds, so I'm going to be pushing that for 30 seconds.
It's going.
Going?
Yeah. Keep going. Keep going. Yeah. Well, I'm seeing the red light, so I know it's on. Yeah. So we've got 30 second exposure. Matt's pushing the car. And it's still going, so it's going to be a while. But the effect you get, stop. Okay, so that's that. It's a shame you didn't have the plane there. That'd have been awesome. So that's one shot that you want, yeah? Are you happy with that?
Yeah.
So you are?
I'm now going to change the exposure.
Yeah.
To 13.
one thirteenth of a second.
Yeah, that's it. Nope, 13 seconds, sorry, not 1/13.
13 seconds.
Just, it might go 15. Just because sometimes if you go too much with it, it looks as though the car is then floating because there's too much creaminess in the tarmac.
Gotcha.
So if you do a shorter exposure, you bring a bit more detail, a bit more, I don't want to say grain, but it brings a bit more detail into the road, so yeah. It actually looks like the car is still planted.
Right, gotcha.
Right. So
yeah,
set
so
up.
Set up for 15 seconds on 15 this
seconds.
One.
So we'll do the same thing again.
Just to reiterate, the first one was 30 seconds. So I'll wait until Matt's ready. Are you ready?
Yeah,
going in. Okay, I'm pressing the button now. Stop. So that's a 15 second exposure. And like Matt said,
so I might not necessarily use it. It depends what it looks like when I can see the full image on my
Well, mirror. You're only here once, so you've got to get the best out exactly. of everything.
Exactly. So now we're now going to, because I've got the two exposures for motion, we're now going to sit Andy in the car and get an exposure with the driver in it. So obviously we don't want to look like, you know, the car's good. Got to be driven, hasn't it? It can't have nobody in it. So yeah, if you want to get into the car, please, Andy, then I'll reset the settings. I'm resetting the settings on the camera to a shorter exposure. I was always told that, you know, a 60th of a second was okay for handheld, wasn't it, for a static?
Yeah, because your eyes blink at 30.
For a static image. So I'll be looking to set the camera now at 1/60th of a second so I can take a photo of Andy in the car so the car looks like it's got a driver in it. And then when I get home and get onto the Mac, the images will then be layered and I'll bring the relevant
elements in
to create the final image.
Yep, good. So like I say, fast exposure for this one. And like Matt said, he'll just layer it together in Photoshop or...
That's it, look like you're driving.
Are you okay with that?
Yeah. That'll do.
Yeah, so you got your polarizer on to cut through the glass.
Yep.
So you can actually see the driver.
Just for good luck, I might just change that again. Just to see if I can cut a little bit more glare out. And you know what, it's where I wanted it to be anyway, so I'm not going to do that. So
happy,
yeah,
cool,
yeah.
So that, guys, is your rig shot, and as you can see, it's quite a phenomenal piece of kit. So that's Matthew Wheeler at Heel and Toe Photography. Check him out, he's pretty damn good at what he does, and the best I know anyway out there. So yeah, brilliant stuff, and what a fantastic car, what a fantastic experience we've had today. It really is, really has been great. And just for finishing off, we get that lovely sound of the V8. Beautiful. Well, what a lovely car, Andy.
Thanks, buddy.
And yeah, it's been a pleasure today. It really has.
I've enjoyed it.
You've enjoyed it?
Yeah, enjoyed driving.
The plane. I thought it was going to land on us.
It was a pretty close call.
It certainly was. Wow, what an experience. And you know, what a plan as well, just to come on here and this old aerodrome here and do this today. It's been fantastic. Yeah. And wow, you know,
what a car.
Yeah. Not just all about the car, but Matthew Wheeler's photography as well. I mean, you know, that's next to none. He's a very talented guy.
He is. Looking forward to seeing the final props.
Absolutely. So am I. But we're going to have them at the end of this video. So you'll see them at the end of the video. All the photos of today will be at the end of the video, and we'll go from there. So anyway, guys, for now, I'm going to bid you all farewell. Matt, Andy, see you later, guys. Cheers. Thank you very much. It's been a lovely old job. Hey! Go,
go beast on them. I go beast. Go deep, I OD on them. Apply pressure, put heat on them.
Put that heat.
5 0 degrees on them.
500 degrees.
Go dummy, go beast on them.
I go beast.
Go deep, I OD on them.
OD.
Apply pressure, put heat on them.
Put that
5 0 degrees on them.
500 degrees.
Countdown, levitate. Going up, elevate. Watch me demonstrate. On time, never late. I grind, celebrate. No pump fake, hesitate. I've been scoring every day. Champagne Perrier. Since 9-3, been in the box. Now stepping up to home. Like straight out the sand lot. Now I'm plotting on the globe. I work hard, I show love. That calm and steady grind. Got this far, I go hard. Let God take control. I was starving, skinny, now my weight up. Got no energy for haters. See you trying, see you later.
See you later.
I'm shooting for the stars, need no laser beam. Blowing like the greatest, but it's one who's always greater.
Yo.
Go dummy, go beast on them.
I go beast.
Go deep, I OD on
them.
Apply pressure, put heat on them.
Put that heat.
5 0 degrees on them.
500 degrees.
Go dummy, go beast on them.
I go beast.
Go deep, I OD on
them.
Apply pressure, put heat on them. Skin clear, this here my year.
Yeah.
Hey, look up here.
Up here.
This here my tier. Same fit 4 days.
4 days.
I grind 4 ways.
4 ways.
I play no games.
No games.
All me, no blame. On the ways, my own way.
Okay. Ready to go?
Ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1, go.
Oh my God. Oh my word. That has got some poke. Oh, wow. God, Jesus. That is pretty awesome. Amazing. What's the 0-60?
Just under 3 seconds. I think it's just over 3 seconds.
Just over 3 seconds. Oh my God. Wow.
Something in it.
I'll tell you what.
For me, personally, I wish this was perfect.
Yeah.
I'm struggling to get out.
To be honest, we're looking at it when you're coming back. I've got some abuse today, to be fair.
Oh, mate. Incredible. I'll tell you what, as you get older, fear does get more and more.
Really?
Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does.